We consider now the single origin all destinations shortest path problem. And we will introduce the shortest path algorithm that will exploit the labels. The idea is that if the labels do not verify the optimality conditions that we have seen, they will be updated. And actually, the labels will be interpreted as the length of a path from the origin to the given nodes. And this intuition will allow us to understand the way the algorithm is working. If you remember, the optimality conditions are based on the labels. They say that for each arc in the network, the label of node j must be less or equal to the label of node I plus the cost of the arc. And for all arcs in the shortest path, you need to have the equality. Let's consider an example. We have this arc ij with a cost which is 1. The label of node I is equal to 3. The interpretation that we give to this value of the label is that the algorithm in a previous iteration has identified a path with length 3. So a path from the origin O to node I with length 3. Now if we follow the arc ij, well, we find a longer path from O to j of length 4, which is 3 plus 4. Now we reach node j and we look at what happens at node j. In node j, we have a label which in this example is equal to 5. So again, it means that previously the algorithm has found a path from O to j of length 5. But now we have found a new path from O to j. This one, the path that goes from O to I and then takes the arc ij. This path has a length which is 3 plus 1, which is 4. Therefore, what the algorithm is doing is to update the value of the label here by the new value. Somehow we impose the fact that lambda j is equal to lambda I plus Cij, because this arc belongs to a path which is shorter than the previous one. Therefore, it's a candidate to be the shortest one. This is the main idea of the algorithm. For each arc ij in the network, if lambda j is strictly greater than lambda I plus Cij, it means that the path that reaches j from I is shorter than any previous path that has been seen by the algorithm. In that case, we update the label of j to the value lambda I plus Cij. That's the main idea of the algorithm. The second idea is that instead of iterating on the arcs, we will actually iterate on the nodes. And we will maintain what we call a set of nodes that I denote by S, and we will treat each node one by one. The algorithm goes as follows. We initialize this node S to the origin node. So in the beginning, the set of nodes contain only one node, the node O, and we initialize the labels. We put 0 for lambda O. Remember, we will interpret the labels as the distance of a path from O to a node, and of course a path from O to O has length 0, so this is a good interpretation. And because we have not seen any node yet, we initialize the labels of all the other nodes to plus infinity. And one iteration of the algorithm starts by selecting a node in S and by looking at all the arcs going out of that node. And then we apply the previous idea that we have presented. If the label of node j is strictly greater than the label of node I plus Cij, then we update the value of the label. Now what we need to do is to verify if the network does not contain a cycle with negative cost. This is the role of this statement here. It says that if the label happens to be negative, it means that we have found a path from the origin to node j of negative length. We need to check if we are below the lower bound that we have derived previously. If we are below the lower bound of a simple path, then it means that the problem is not bounded. There is a negative cost cycle in the network, and we can stop immediately. If not, because we have updated the value of lambda j, then we add node J to the set of nodes so that it will be treated later on. Once we have processed all the arcs leaving node I, we can remove node I from the set S. It has been treated. And we repeat this until the set of nodes is empty and there is no node to treat anymore. The shortest path algorithm updates the labels of the nodes at each iteration. It maintains a set of nodes that have to be processed. Processing a node means looking at all the outgoing arcs from that node and possibly update the labels of the downstream node if needed. In that case, that node is inserted in the set of nodes. And the algorithm will finish the iterations either if the set of nodes to be processed is empty or if a cycle of negative cost has been detected and the problem has no shortest path.